Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the NASCAR room of my dreams. This is my version of the ultimate NASCAR diecast and merchandise man cave. I will be taking you on a little bit of a tour to show you everything I have displayed. First, on this little centerpiece here by the door, I have two Jeff Gordon hats that I love very, very much. The rainbow and the last ride hat with a little bit of a Jeff Gordon pit stop picture. Next up is this Dale Jr. autograph poster that I won for being in the top 10 in one of the Paint the 88 competitions back in 2009 or 2010. And then this behind my TV is a wall of NASCAR Authentics. This is where I'm going to display all my packaged NASCAR Authentics right behind my TV. I can't wait to see them grow. And then the TV shelf. Underneath it is a diecast display filled with Jeff Gordon, William Byron, Chase Elliott, Carl Edwards, Jamie McMurray, and others of my favorite 124 diecasts that I own. You see here some of Jeff Gordon's later paint schemes that transition into William Byron, then Jamie McMurray and some Aflac and Carl Edwards paint schemes, and then a lot of Chase Elliott Xfinity and Nationwide Series race cars. Now as we pan out, here's what it looks like from afar. Those Authentics look really good, hung on the wall. Next, I have a little bit of a miniature Jeff Gordon display filled with my favorite Jeff Gordon diecast that I own. There's a 164 still in the box. The 2007 Talladega win, his last win, his 2012 Homestead win, the liquid color Rainbow Warrior throwback, his final ride, and then there's a Star Wars race win from Talladega in 2005. Next up is a shelf of all 164 diecasts consisted of Jeff Gordon, Chase Elliott, Dale Jr., and Dale Earnhardt Sr. First off are the Jeff Gordon diecasts that go in chronological order, starting from his final season, which was 2015, all the way down to 1993. You can pause the video whenever you would like to see which diecasts that I have, but here's a little bit of a pan and zoom of the cars that I own of Jeff Gordon. Here's the early 2000s era of Jeff Gordon, and we dip below. We're going to go into the 1990s when Jeff Gordon was the most dominant driver. There's a little bit of a peek of the Jurassic Park race car, and then you see Michael Annett's throwback scheme. I put it up there because I actually have two of those, and it's a Jeff Gordon throwback, so why not? And then Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s display. I love Dale Jr. for multiple reasons. One, because it's Dale Jr. Two, because of my dad. My love for my dad is incredible, and it wouldn't be a good tribute to my NASCAR room if it wasn't for the man who got me into NASCAR as a little boy, practically before I was even born. So this shelf also is dedicated to my dad for his love for Dale Jr. and Dale Earnhardt Sr. Now here's Dale Jr.'s Xfinity Series race cars all the way back to the Grand National days. And then below here is Dale Earnhardt Sr. race cars. I have not as many Dale Earnhardt Sr. cars, mainly because he mainly drove the good wrench scheme, but I tried to collect as many as I could. There's the 2000 All-Star Paint scheme, the Tasmanian Devil Daytona 500 scheme. That Oreo scheme is one of my favorites. That's the Bud Shootout scheme from 2001. Then we dip below into Chase Elliott. Now, if you noticed, everyone went from down a year, but Chase Elliott's going to grow up a year because he's still a current driver, so it goes from 2016 all the way up to present day 2020. And then that Dale Jr. filter time iRacing car I still just haven't put in the right spot. And then right here is a little Jeff Gordon race car carrier inside that you can carry 164 cars, but I don't just because I want to display them. And right here is a little bit of a 124 shelf with mainly Chase Elliott diecasts. And then above there is a Chase Elliott shrine, just a little miniature Chase Elliott shrine with his 2018 Dover win, his 2019 Watkins Glen win, and then my favorite win of his young career, the 2019 Roval win where he drove into the barrier and then came all the way back. In the box, I still have his Watkins Glen first victory, a first victory hat, and up here I have his Kansas win in 164 and then his first win in 164. Then there's the Sun Energy first win, Mountain Dew Kansas win, Talladega Little Caesars win. Then there's just the Hooters and Baja Blast cars that I love a lot, mainly because I like the paint scheme and they are autographed. And this is what it looks like from afar. Up top here, I have some hats. Two of them are signed by Chase Elliott, and the Jeff Gordon hat is my first ever Chase Elliott signature. Next up, the man that's in one of my first ever usernames, JM26. It's Jamie McMurray. I had to dedicate a little shrine to McMurray because I love him so much too, and I have to show my dedication and pride for Jamie McMurray and all the cool race cars he drove throughout his career. Then I have some of my favorite McMurray hats, and the bottom two are autographed. This is a little shelf dedicated to the Xfinity Nationwide and Busch series. So there's an assortment of Busch cars here that go up by number, not year, just numbers. So there's some of my favorites. And over here is a Jeff Gordon hat with the DuPont flames on it, number 24. It's got his championship years on the strap. And then here's a little picture of Jeff Gordon winning the 2005 Daytona 500. And then there's a ticket from that race. And then this hat just kind of matched the theme, the DuPont theme there, so I hung it up right next to there. This is a built-in shelf when I got the room. When we moved into the house, I figured this would be a great spot to display some of my random merchandise that aren't exactly die-cast. There are some die-casts in there, but they're like part of memorabilia that NASCAR was really hyped up in the late 90s and early 2000s, thanks to Dale Earnhardt Sr. and Jeff Gordon. This is a picture I got for Christmas by a family friend. It has a bunch of tracks, aerial view from afar above, and it is really old because North Wilkesboro's on there and Bristol's on there without the Coliseum. Then this shelf is going to be a primary shelf for each year, but on top of it, I have some of my favorite 124 diecasts, and this is one of my favorites too. This Carl Edwards is autographed by both Jack Roush and Carl Edwards himself. And there's a Kyle Busch throwback that I love, Dale Sr.'s last win, Kyle Larson's first win, and a Dale Jr. Budweiser throwback. So this is 1994 you're looking at right here. These are the primary schemes from there. It jumps up to 1995. And then 94 and 95 are pretty consistent, but 96, 97, 98 are a little fuzzy. I wasn't kind to my cars when I was a kid, and then I just never collected all of them. I just got them from the $1 bins at the racetrack, so I'll have to work on the collection. But 99 and up is pretty consistent. There are some that I am missing, admittedly, but that is one day hopefully going to be taken care of slowly over time. And some of them you don't see the primary schemes. Maybe you see some, a couple popular secondary schemes. That's just because when I was young, me and my dad kind of had a mutual agreement that if it was the same exact paint scheme, we didn't necessarily need to spend money on it the next year. So slowly over time, I've been rolling in, trying to get just to collect at least the primaries of each year. So if you do see some secondary paint schemes, like I just saw one right there with Casey Kane, it's just because I never was able to get that. And a lot of these cars are actually fairly expensive these days. So it's kind of understandable if I don't try and get those immediately, because one, they're a lot of money, and two, I'm pretty content with my collection as well, but it is nice to have satisfyingly good-looking primary schemes all together. And then here's the 2000s. The 2000s have a lot of double schemes, but if you remember, in the year 2000, NASCAR introduced the Car of Tomorrow. So some cars, some races we ran the COY, and the others we ran the COT. Then this shelf is 2008 on up, but on top I have some cars, 164s, that I left in boxes, either because I think they are nice looking cars and could possibly be valuable someday, and two, they have nice box art. So you see there's also Eric Jones' first win. The Carl Edwards cars are actually autographed, so I'm trying to preserve those. So here's the start of 2009 and the end of 2008 here on the first row. And then these cars are especially nostalgic to me because when I started the Affleck Cup Series was the year 2009. So 2008 cars and 2009 cars are especially nostalgic for me because that was season 1 and season 2 of the Affleck Cup Series. 2011 was season 3. And then here's 2012 cars. That was season 4. Season 5 kicked off in 2013. And then season 6 was 2014. So you see a mix on this shelf is 2013 and beginning of 2014. We dip below there to see Clint Boyer Peak cars because I don't have the primary like I explained earlier. And here's 2015. 2015 is a nostalgic year for me too, because that was the first ever time I really got into custom diecast. So you see some custom diecast cars that I bought from friends, and then is also a 36 race Aflac Cup Series season. And it went so long, it dipped into 2016. So 2015 and 2016 is season 7. Then a little bit of 2016 and 2017 is season 8. Season 9 was 2018 cars, which we'll be getting to on the next shelf here after these 2017 cars. And there's 2018. When I look at those cars, I think of season 9. And then here, these cars right here, 2019, I think of season 10. And then the bottom here, you can tell by the Cup Series banners on them that these are 2020 race cars. I'm very, very happy with this primary scheme collection theme I got going here. But as you can see, the shelves are getting full, so I may either have to start just collecting based on 2000 and up. So right here, I have a Jeff Gordon flag, but if you unhook it, behind there is a closet. So I have some football jerseys, hockey jerseys, and NASCAR memorabilia hung up. I have my other race cars in the boxes that aren't primary schemes. And then up here, I have cups and stuff I use for my stop motions. There's arts and crafts boxes there organized with stuff in them. So my closet is very, very helpful for this NASCAR room. Now right here, you can see I kind of have like a makeshift dresser with cubby boxes filled with NASCAR t-shirts. Each one is chocked full. This one's a random driver shirt, so I have like Casey Kane's in there and stuff like that. This one is all Chase Elliott's. And then the next box up is more Jeff Gordon's. I have a lot of Jeff Gordon t-shirts. I'm sure by the theme of the room, you could tell why I have a lot of Jeff Gordon and Chase Elliott t-shirts. So here are my hats, lots of rows of them. I have some hung up on the walls, but others I still have there to display. This shelf is mainly going to be used for cars I'm collecting currently, and it's also going to hold my trucks, my IROC cars, and then I have my Ricky Bobby Talladega Nights cars displayed, and the Winston Cup Champion cars. There's a Carl Edwards throwback with some rare cars from the mid-2000s. There's a custom 124 my brother made for me, a Jeff Gordon Daytona win. Dale Jr. Elvis next to a Dale Sr. clock that doesn't work. A Bill Elliott hat, and there's my lanyards. So when I hit the track, I can just grab and go. Some more custom cars made by my brother. And yeah, that's the man cave that I've been working on. I'm so proud. It took me a while to plan things out, but I'm so happy how this thing turned out. It's very incredible to have this, and I'm very thankful. So let me know if you want more videos on this room. I could do live streams in this room. I'd love to do that. So just let me know what you want me to do. So hope everybody is doing well, and I will see you guys in future videos. Peace out.